The next topic in this chapter is interdependence between plants and animals. That means how plants and animals are dependent on each other. So what is the relation between plants and animals? So in the previous topic we have discussed that leaves can prepare their food with the help of the chlorophyll present in them. So during the process of photosynthesis, the leaves will give off oxygen into the atmosphere. So during the process of photosynthesis, the leaves can prepare their food. That means they will mixes. That means they will combine the water, minerals, and carbon dioxide present in the air. And in the presence of sunlight, those water, minerals and carbon dioxide will be converted into their food. And during the process of photosynthesis, the leaves will give out oxygen. So they give off oxygen into the atmosphere. And this oxygen is very, very helpful to all living beings. That means all plants and all animals and human beings. So this oxygen will be taken by the animals. So the animals will breathe in this oxygen and they are able to survive. Next, this photosynthesis process, the leaves will prepare their food. That means they will prepare fruits and vegetables. So fruit means the leaves will prepare their food in the form of fruits and vegetables. And these fruits and vegetables are very useful for the animals. So children, so plants will give food for the animals and gives oxygen for the animals. So without oxygen and without food, the living beings cannot survive on the earth. So that in this way, the plants are producing oxygen, which are very helpful for the animals, and they produce food, that means fruits and vegetables for the animals. And with the help of this food, they can get energy and they can perform various type of activities in their lives. So in this way, the plants are very, very helpful to the animals. And again, in the same way, these animals will give off carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. That means the animals will breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. And this carbon dioxide will be utilized in the photosynthesis process by the plants. So, the given out carbon dioxide by the animals is helpful for the plants in preparing the food. So, that means the both plants and animals will depend upon each other, because the plants gives oxygen and food for the animals, and animals will give carbon dioxide to the plants. So, without animals, there are no plants. And without plants, there are no animals. So in this way, the both plants and animals will depend upon each other. So that's why there should be a balance between plants and animals in the environment. We have to keep the both plants and animals in our environment. There only be, then a natural balance will be occurred in the surroundings. So children, now learn about some functions of leaves. Up to now we have discussed what is the leaf and what are the different parts of leaves and what are the uses of leaves. Now we are going to learn about the functions of leaves. So what are the functions of leaves? So the first one is, so these plants gives shadow in during hot summer days and cools the environment. For example, some trees like banyan tree, mango tree, neem tree. So these are the trees which gives an extensive shadow during the hot summer days. So the first function is gives shadow. So gives shadow during hot summer days and cools the environment. Next, the second one is, the rotten leaves, that means the fallen leaves rot and gives and makes the soil humus. So during some seasons, the trees will fall in their leaves to prevent the loss of water. So during some seasons, so the plants will fall their leaves, so to prevent the loss of water and to retain the water in their bodies. And those fallen leaves will decomposed and converted into some compost and will become rot. And those fallen leaves becomes rot and becomes compost and makes the soil very humus. And the soil is very helpful for the plants for their healthy growth, and it will give nutrients to the soil. So in this way, the fallen leaves becomes rot and makes the soil humus. So this is one more function. And next one is, these leaves block the wind. So blocks the wind and also the soil from the soil erosion. So soil erosion. So during the cyclone times, so the water will flow on the ground and the water will take away the humus soil present on the upper parts of the soil. So because of these plants will prevent the soil from the soil erosion during rainy days and during the cyclone times. So that's why these leaves blocks the winds and blocks the soil and prevents the soil from the soil erosion. Next, another function is, so they will respirates, that means they will gives out water vapor. They will gives out water vapor. So because the leaves contains small pores on its surface. The leaves have small pores on its surface. That small pores are called stomata. So the small pores are called stomata, and this stomata will gives out water vapor into the atmosphere. So just like in human beings, we have sweat glands on their skin. So in the same way, the plants have also some holes in their leaves. That holes are called stomata, and the excess water comes out through this stomata into the atmosphere as a water vapor. So this water vapor comes out from the stomata of the leaves, cools the atmosphere, so cools the surroundings. So the water vapor gives out by the leaves and cools the environment. So this is the one more function of the leaves. And another function, important function is, the leaves will prepare food for the plant. So they will prepare food for the plants. So by using the process of photosynthesis, that means in the presence of sunlight, these leaves mixes the water, minerals and carbon dioxide present in the water and prepares the food, which is called glucose. So the important function of the leaves is prepare food for the plant. And also they will give food. So these leaves will give food for the animals. So some animals like herbivores, so the animals which eat only plants and grass are called herbivores. So for those animals, so they eat the leaves of the plant. So they will give food for the animals. And another function is, they will absorb the noise in our surroundings and reduces noise pollution. So another important function of the leaves is reduces noise pollution. So how they reduce noise pollution means, they absorb the noise and disturbances present in our surroundings and reduces the noise pollution in our surroundings. So these are the some functions of the leaves. The first one is gives shadow during hot summer days. and the fallen leaves becomes rot and decompose and makes the soil humus. That means provides the soil humus. And this humus soils are very helpful for the plants for their healthy growth. And third one is blocks winds and prevents the soil from the soil erosion. And another one is they gives out water vapor which cools the surrounding environment. Another one is they prepare food for the plant. And they gives food for the plant eaters, that means herbivorous animals. And another one is reduces noise pollution in our surroundings. So children, so these are the functions of the leaves.